Jill Farrar. I'm the nursery coordinator at Memorial Park Church. And here we really value and understand the joys and triumphs and tribulations it takes for new parents to welcome a new infant into their home. So one of the first things we do at Memorial Park once we hear of a member's new baby is we visit them at their home and we bring them a home-cooked meal along with a lullaby CD and the different materials that the nursery offers on our staff and how it's our pleasure to really care for their infant while they worship and let them know that they're really the first ones in this new person's life to make a spiritual impact on them.
Memorial Park has been a great gift to our family. The Children's Ministry Program has been fantastic in helping to create a nurturing environment for our children to learn about their love for Christ. There have been a lot of wonderful activities and the church really has come alongside our family to help us to encourage our children to be Christ-like followers.
Absolutely. With the involvement of the ministries in the church itself, they have been able to get involved in other ministries in the church to connect with not only other kids but special needs kids and show their compassion and love for others and Christ all in the same at the same time with expressing and being with other people in the church.
Baptism is a symbolic gesture from parents that this child is now being welcomed into a faith community. So here at Memorial Park, we are looking to make baptism be more about the faith community than an individual event that's just for the family, but instead bringing that child into the whole faith community. And so we're seeking ways to make this more of a family ministry event. So it starts at a baptism class that a group of families all attend together with their babies, who get to spend some time in the nursery with the nursery coordinator and becoming comfortable with the nursery and the policies and the procedures and the workers and the environment, realizing that this is a safe place for their baby to come and that they're welcome here, while the parents are downstairs partaking in a class. And at the class, the pastors attend and they teach the theological background for baptism and why we baptize babies, while also the family ministries team is present and they are teaching parents practical ways that they can develop their child's spiritual faith in the first couple of years of their lives. Also at the class, the parents receive a customized frame and mat with their child's name and the date that they are baptized into the church. And at that time, they also, each, the parents, the pastors, the family ministries team, the nursery team, each imprint their fingerprints onto the mat, showing that they are imprinting their lives into this baby, and that they are going to invest in the child throughout their spiritual journey. And it's making this just more of an intentional act to be investing into the life of this child. And then at the baptism Sunday, the mat is also put out where other members of the faith community can also join in imprinting their lives into the life of this child and adding their thumbprints to the picture frame to make this just a greater celebration of the whole church family.
To the children's ministry at Memorial Park Church is just doing a fabulous job of coming alongside families to support us in growing our children in the faith. And they do this from wee little all the way up till the time that they are graduating and heading out to college. But I will remember when we had our youngest was born while we were members here, and we received a Bible and a little book and a lullaby CD just as gifts for parents that I just thought was so sweet. The church was going out of their way to give us scriptural material to read over our baby when he was born, and I thought, oh, we're in good hands here. We were fairly new members at the time, so it was just a sweet way of them reaching out to love on us, even with our newborn. But then as they grew, we had chances to we received devotionals to do with our children when they were also like preschool aged, which was really hands-on. It was a wonderful tool for us to be able to sit down at home with our kids before they go to bed. We would read the Bible story and then do that little devotional together, and it was just a good way of again expanding their faith. And it was a tool that we were given by Children's Ministries that helped us be able to sit down and do it together as a family at home.